Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create a stick figure walk cycle in PowerPoint 2016. And that is a very simple tutorial and you might have guessed that already. So let's get started. So let me show you the objects that I have used in this presentation. And for that, go to the Home tab, click Select drop-down button and choose Selection Pen. And here you can see that only 5 objects has been used. For the head, I have used a circle or what you can call a oval from the Shapes drop-down menu. And here you can see that I have used an oval here. And for the body part, I have used Freeform Shape Tool. And you can easily draw this kind of shapes in using Freeform by just clicking first here, then just click here, and then close the path. And then from the format tab, you can use the edit shapes, edit point command to change the shape. So you can easily give the curves using the edit point command and can adjust the shape according to your requirement. So I hope you might got my point here. And using the same command, I have drawn these shoes here, just like that. And then use edit points. You can zoom in to easily change the size of a shape. And I just did like that. Okay. So now let me open the animation pan, and as you can see that a very few animations has been used here. And even it is easy because on the left foot there has been 3 animations that I have applied on the left foot, so the same animations are repeating on the right foot. So that will be very easy, that 3 and 3 6 and only 7 animation you have to apply for yourself. And then we will use animation painter to copy the same effect of left foot to the right foot. So let's get started, and let me delete all of these animation first. Now zoom out a little bit and select the head. And for the head, I first will apply the motion path. And for that, go to the animations tab, click add animation drop down button and choose more motion paths. And here I will choose up motion path. Then zoom out and adjust the path length. And I will make it a little bit diagonal here. Just like that. That much is fine. Set it to play with previous with the duration of 1.25 seconds. Let me tell you one thing, that duration, delay are totally depend on you, that how you want to move the objects, quicker or slower. So the duration of the animation decide that the object will move quicker or slower. So the next thing will be open the effect option and let the smooth start and end remain as the default values. And set it to auto reverse. I want the head to move back to its original position after moving up. And from in the timing tab, set it to repeat until end of the slide. So it is up to you that how much far you want the head to go. You can shorten the length or you can also increase the length. That much is enough, I think. So the next animation will be on body. So I will select the body and will zoom in. And for the body, I am going to use the same animation as I have used for head. So I will select the head, click animation painter, and then click on the body. Okay, that's fine. And on the body, I will apply another animation, and that will be spin, and set it to play with previous. Open the effect option window. And I just want to spin this object a little bit, just 2 degrees clockwise, and set it to auto reverse. I want the body to go back to its original position after rotating 2 degrees clockwise, and set it to repeat until end of the slide. and the duration of this animation will be 1 second, and I don't want any delay. I want the body to spin right away with the motion path. Hit the OK button and let me show you the slideshow. And also I will set the setup slideshow loop until escape. Now see the slideshow, and you can see a glitch in PowerPoint that if you rotate an object to a very short amount, just like I have given 2 degrees, then you can see a glitch here that it doesn't properly show the spin animation here. And as you can see, a bit glitches here, and the animation is not very smooth. And that is because, let me show you another example here. If I draw a rectangle, let's say that is 1 by 1 rectangle, I am going to shorten it just like that. Okay, and now if I apply this object the grow shrink effect and set it to play with previous, let me shorten the duration to 1 second, and I want this object size to be huge, 400%, and that is the maximum amount that you can put in grow and shrink. Hit the OK button and let's see the preview. And you can see that it is already distorted, and that is what I am talking about, that PowerPoint is not very good in graphics. Even if you have a graphic card in your system, just like I have this Nvidia GeForce GT640 and Intel HD Graphics 4400, but I don't think that really much matter in PowerPoint, because PowerPoint doesn't handle graphics very well, and I will show you that in my next tutorials. Okay, now let's move to the left foot. And for the left foot, I will first apply a motion path, and that will be arc. Arc up. Hit the OK button, and you have to shorten the length of this motion path. I just want to move this path. Let me zoom in. Okay. I just want to move that path right here. Okay. And I don't want that much of height, so I will shorten it just like that. Okay. Now I will change the effect option. So for that, I will double click on the effect. So I need start and end smoothness here, but don't want to auto reverse this effect, and want to repeat it until an end of the slide, and want to play it with previous with a duration of around 1.25 seconds without any delay timings. Hit the OK button and let's see the slideshow. Okay. The next thing will be, I want this foot to move back to its original position, and for that I will apply another motion path, and that will be left motion path. Hit the OK button, and you have to set the left motion path starting point right from here, where the arc up path is ending, and the ending position will be just right here. Okay, let's zoom in and adjust the path properly. Select the animation right from this animation pan, and then you can easily adjust the path length. Okay, I think that's fine here. Okay, I need smoothness for this animation as well. Don't want to auto reverse this effect, and go to the timing tab, set it to play with previous with a delay timing of 1.25 seconds and also the and with same duration, and want to repeat this effect until end of the slide. Now let's see the slideshow. Okay, the next effect will be spin. So go to add animation, apply spin animation, set it to play with previous, set a duration of around 0.62 seconds, hit the enter key, and a delay timing of 0.50. Open the effect option. I don't want any smoothness for the spin, and want to rotate this foot to 8 degrees counterclockwise, and want auto reverse for this effect. I want the foot to move 8 degree up and then reverse back to its original position. And in the timing tab, I also want to repeat this effect until end of the slide. So everything is fine here, and hit the OK button. Let's see the slideshow. So as the foot will move to the paths, it will also spin up to 8 degree. Okay, now the same animations will be used on the right foot. And what you can do, you can select the right foot, you can select the left foot and then click on animation painter and then click on the right foot. What you only need to do here is to change the paths. And you can easily do that by selecting the one animation in a time and then select that animation from the path and just move it right here. Okay, now select the right foot and then move it right here. The only thing you need to change here is you need to change the animation position. Like right foot will be first here, the left motion path will be up. Just like we have arc up motion path for the left foot on the top, but for the right foot, we will move the right foot to the left first and then it will jump back to its original position using the arc path. So that is why I have moved this right foot on the top by just dragging and dropping. And for the right foot, I will add a delay timing of 1.25 for the arc path. Okay, everything is fine. And for the shadow, select the shadow, add animation, grow and shrink with previous, open the effect option, set it to auto reverse with a size of 150% is fine, and repeat it until end of the slide. Now let's see the slideshow. Okay, that's fine, I think, and I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below. And if you find this video informative, then don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. You can also subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.